Let me ask you something. Have you ever been eyeing something imported? You know, a phone, a new pair of sneakers, maybe even a car, and the price just seems to change? It can feel totally random, right? Well, I promise you it's not. And we're about to pull back the curtain and show you exactly what's going on. Seriously, think about it. You check the price of that amazing car you've been dreaming of, the one from Germany or Japan. A month later, you look again and poof, the price is completely different. How does that happen? And that's the part that really messes with your head, isn't it? The sticker price in dollars, or euros, or yen, it hasn't budged one bit. So why is the price you'd actually pay in your local currency doing this wild dance? Well, the answer is hiding in plain sight, and it all comes down to a couple of little numbers. And that brings us to what I like to call the secret code. Now, it's not really a secret, but it is this incredibly powerful little formula that controls the prices of pretty much everything we import. So let's crack it together, shall we? You know, it's actually beautifully simple when you break it down. You only need two pieces of the puzzle to figure out the local price of anything that's come from another country. All right, first up is the obvious part, the price of the item in its own currency. So, for our example, let's just say we have a car with a fixed price tag of $10,000. Easy enough. And now, for the magic ingredient, the exchange rate. This little number is the key. It tells you how much of your money it takes to buy just one unit of a foreign currency, like one US dollar. We're going to start with a nice round number, an exchange rate of 4.0. Okay, so here it is. This is the whole shebang. The local price you pay is just the foreign price multiplied by the exchange rate. That's it. This simple formula is the engine that drives all those price changes we've been talking about. So let's plug our numbers in and see what happens. We take that $10,000 foreign price of the car and we multiply it by our starting exchange rate of 4.0. And there we go. The price for that car in our local currency is $40,000. Simple, right? At this exact moment in time, with this specific exchange rate, that is the price. Ah, but here's where the story really gets interesting. Because that exchange rate, it is not set in stone. It moves, sometimes a little, sometimes a lot, every single day. So what happens when that number goes up? And that brings us to our first big idea. When that exchange rate number gets bigger, it means your local currency is actually getting weaker. There's a name for this in economics, and it's called depreciation. All depreciation means is that your money's value has dropped a bit compared to another currency. So you need more of your money, more pesos, more rupees, whatever it is, to buy that exact same single US dollar. Your purchasing power abroad just took a little hit. So let's imagine the market shifts and that rate moves from 4.0 all the way up to 5.0. This is a classic example of your currency depreciating. That US dollar just got more expensive for you to buy. So let's go back to our formula. Remember, the car still costs $10,000. That part hasn't changed at all. But now we have to multiply it by our new higher exchange rate of 5.0. And boom, the local price shoots up to $50,000. The car is the exact same car it was yesterday, but because your currency depreciated, it now costs you a whopping $10,000 more to get it. That's the power of the exchange rate right there. But of course, this is a two-way street. It can absolutely go the other way. And when your currency gets stronger, we have a different, much happier term for it, appreciation. Yep, appreciation is the awesome flip side. It means your currency has gained value. So now you actually need less of your local money to buy that same single US dollar. Your purchasing power just went up. Okay, so let's imagine the rate drops this time, falling from our original 4.0 all the way down to 3.0. This is what appreciation looks like in the numbers. The exchange rate actually gets smaller. Back to our trusty formula one more time. The foreign price is still our constant $10,000, but now we get to multiply it by this new lower exchange rate of 3.0. And would you look at that? The local price plummets to $30,000. All of a sudden, that imported car is a fantastic deal. It's $10,000 less than when we started, all because your home currency got stronger. So let's just put it all together real quick. Depreciation means a higher exchange rate number, and that makes imported goods more expensive for you. Appreciation means a lower exchange rate number, which makes those exact same imports cheaper. Simple as that. Okay, that's the theory, and it's a neat little math trick. But why should you actually care? Well, because this formula isn't just theory. It is quietly at work all around you every single day, affecting the money right there in your wallet. I mean, think about it. That smartphone in your pocket, maybe the shirt you're wearing, the laptop you're watching this on. If any of it was imported, its price is constantly being nudged by these rates. Planning a vacation abroad? A strong currency, appreciation, means your trip just got a whole lot cheaper. Love shopping online from international stores? The final price you pay at checkout can change from one day to the next, all because of this. So, from now on, when you see the price of an imported product wiggle up or down, you'll know exactly what's going on behind the scenes. You have the code. So my question to you is, with this new lens, what's the first price tag you're going to look at and finally truly understand?